The Americans fly deeper into France, almost to the German border. The German fighters, high over Karlsruhe, wait for the American bombers to come to them. Once the American fighters leave the bombers, the Germans will make their attack.
Jocko leader to Cowhide leader. Bogey's 1 o'clock.
Germans do not attack. They are bewildered. The escorting American fighters have not broken off. They are accompanying the bombers deeper into Germany than ever before. The bombers are approaching the target. The Germans are running out of fuel. If they are ever to make their attack, they must come in now.
Clock, strip tanks and brake left.
Germans are engaged and defeated by long-range American fighters.
Stars are in the blue, long as there's a spring of bird to sing, I'll go on loving you till the end of time, long as roses bloom in May, my love for you deeper with every passing day, till the wells run dry and each mountain disappears. I'll be there for you to care for you through laughter and through tears. So take my heart in sweet surrender and tenderly say that I'm the one you love and live for till the end of time. Each mountain disappears. I'll be there for you to care for you through laughter and through tears. So take my heart in sweet surrender and tenderly say that I'm the one you love and live for till the end of time.
On the 24th of October, 2000, a new shape took to the skies. The Lockheed Martin F-35 is the most advanced combat aircraft ever built. It could be in service with the US and British military for the next 50 years. But the extraordinary F-35 would not exist without a secret, long-forgotten ancestor. A plane designed to break the sound barrier before Pearl Harbor. An interceptor that could have swept the skies of Nazi jets in World War II. An aircraft so far in advance of its time that its secrets can still be found in every modern fighter, down to the F-35. This is the story of a legacy. America's first jet fighter project, the Lockheed L-133. Conventional history has it that the jet plane was invented in Europe during World War II, forever changing the face of warfare. The first jet fighter to enter operational service was the German Messerschmitt ME-262 in 1944. Only in the years after the war did America catch up with Europe in jet aircraft design. But we can now reveal this story is not accurate. In the years before Pearl Harbor, a team of America's best aircraft engineers were already working on what was the world's most advanced combat plane. A jet-powered supersonic fighter, the Lockheed L-133. Johnson pointed out that Nazi Germany had flown its first jet in September 1939. That soon, German combat jets would be in service in Europe. But the Army Air Corps refused to fund further work on the L-133. In Europe, the very danger that Johnson had predicted was taking shape. The day of the jet was coming, and America was watching from the sidelines. Nazi Europe, 1943. A reconnaissance version of the fast Lockheed Lightning fighter brings back pictures of strange new German planes. The photographs reveal scorch marks on the runways and grass fields. These aircraft have a new kind of propulsion. They are jets. Fortunately, their experience with the L-133 was to prove invaluable to the Lockheed engineers. The new fighter, designated the P-80, would utilize much of the preliminary design work that had gone into the earlier project. But the P-80 would never go supersonic. When further development of the L-1000 engine was cancelled, America lost the edge in jet engine design. In fact, the P-80 was powered by a British Goblin in a desperate bid to down the Nazi jet reconnaissance planes. A flight of Kelly Johnson's experimental P-80s were rushed to Italy to hunt them.
P-80 was a truly pioneering aircraft. It was a pretty simple airplane, actually, but it was an epic step forward. The objective from the beginning was speed. Speed was the dominant objective of the design, to get a really fast airplane and to take full advantage of a jet engine.
But with only a handful of experimental P-80s available for Italy, the U.S. Army was unable to hunt down the elusive Arados. The lesson was clear. America had lost three vital years in jet warfare when the original Lockheed L-133 project had been cancelled. The only artifact left to record the passing of the L-133 is a solitary prototype of Nathan Price's L-1000 engine, which rests in the Planes of Fame Museum at Chino, California. Few who pass by it realize its historic significance. But what if the L-133 had flown? How would it have fared in combat? Imagine. Pilots of the 365th Pursuit Group have replaced their P-38 Lightnings for the new L-133 jets. The U.S. Army Air Force calls the new fighter the Starjet. On the morning of April the 15th, 1945, history will take place. The first ever jet-to-jet combat. A flight of three Star Jets is on combat air patrol over southern Bavaria. They're escorting B-24 Liberators on a bombing mission against Nazi airfields. Suddenly, a flight of Messerschmitt ME-262s flash out of the sun, heading for the Liberators. But the 262s have made a big error. They have assumed the US escort fighters are slower piston-engined Mustangs. The 262s plan a fast run-in against the Liberators. And then they will outpace the Mustangs and escape. They're in for a terrible shock. The Star Jets of the 365th Pursuit Group accelerate to intercept the approaching 262s. Surprised, the German jets split up. Suddenly and unexpectedly, the 262s find they cannot outpace their American foes. They are being overhauled by the Star Jets. Combat is joined high above the last Nazi redoubt in Bavaria. It is combat to the death at 1,000 kilometers per hour. For the first time in warfare, a jet fighter is shot down by another jet fighter. In reality, no jet-to-jet combat took place in World War II. That had to wait for the Korean War in the 1950s.
Mustang. Only 270 of these unusual planes were built, but they did quite well. Essentially, the F-82 was a hybrid aircraft, formed from two Mustang fuselages, lengthened and joined at the wing and tail, much like the Lockheed P-38 Lightning. However, the P-51 engines gave the twin Mustang a top speed of over 470 miles per hour and a range of 2,200 miles. The F-82 was an effective weapon against enemy ground forces and also scored several kills against Korean MiGs.
Thank you. Boeing B-29 Superfortress, now a decaying hulk. It once crippled an empire, and in a single stroke of terror, ended a war and changed a world forever. Its recurring echo still sounds from those gone but not forgotten days.
Fighters high over Karlsruhe wait for the American bombers to come to them. Once the American fighters leave the bombers, the Germans will make their attack.
Jocko leader to Cowhide leader. Bogey's 1 o'clock. High. Cowhide leader to all elements. Keep the formation tight.
The Germans do not attack. They are bewildered. The escorting American fighters have not broken off. They are accompanying the bombers deeper into Germany than ever before. The bombers are approaching the target. The Germans are running out of fuel. If they are ever to make their attack, they must come in now.
Friendly deterrent flight. Bogies attacking at 5 o'clock. Strip tanks and break left.
Germans are engaged and defeated by long-range American fighters.
Loving you till there's roses bloom in May. My love for you will grow deeper with every passing day, till the wells run dry and each mountain disappears. I'll be there for you to care for you through laughter and through tears. So take my heart in sweet surrender and tenderly say that I'm the one you love and live for till the end of time. Till the wells run dry and each mountain disappears. I'll be there for you to care for you through laughter and through tears. So take my heart in sweet surrender and tenderly say that I'm the one you love and live for till the end of time.
Is gone.